Good evening, everybody. So Friday night, changing it up in terms of broadcasting live webinar. So I'll just wait for everybody to get on board and we'll begin tonight's webinar, a little different format. So I'm hoping people will jump on board real soon. A bit of a delay here as always. So I will let people know when we're good to go, when enough people are on board. So there's usually a 30-second, 40-second delay here. So to remind people, but once you're on board, we're going to change the format tonight. I'll get into that in a second. So hello, Emmy from London. I don't know if that's London, Ontario, Canada or London, England, but nice to have you on board. So I'm just waiting for people to build up. Hey, Janine. So good stuff. Good. I'm just going to get people on board. And then as you can see, topic metabolism in relation to biochemical and hormonal reality. And so we're going to discuss the training elements that are involved with that. And it's a little different. I'm going to discuss blind spots in what people on what people see. So there's going to be a discussion of that, because there's a huge blind spot out there when it comes to training, and that's what I want to get into. So just waiting for everyone to get on board, and then I'm going to begin the subject at hand. I'm going to ask you to put on your observational hats and think about what you see and witness in the gym, and you know, ask you to think about that for a minute, because it's amazing to me how many people are unobservant of what they witness. You know, in terms of what they see works and what they see doesn't work. And we're going to get into that very, very shortly. So really important stuff, I think. But it's a different format. The last several weeks, I've been going pretty much with research and getting you guys to wait till the end in terms of talking about research. And then I go through the research as a presentation, like I used to do when I taught university, etc., and then save your questions to the end. But this is going to be more of a discussion, so going to get everybody involved in that, and then ask you to, like I said, put on your thinking hats and think about things. So kicking off the weekend with the coach, I like it. So good stuff. Let's just maybe wait one more minute and get some people on board. So I want to start asking you a couple things to think about here. And then I will bring in my Word document into the conversation. So one of the things I want you to think about, what you observe in the gym, I want you to think about, if you go to a public gym, consider the following for me. When you think about the exercise classes at your gym, boot camp classes, whatever you want to call them, what is the first observation that you notice when you think about, when I ask you to say, make a general observation about boot camp classes or exercise classes at your gym, what's the first observation that comes to your mind when I ask you to think about that? So as you can see, tonight's going to be more of a discussion, more of a conversation. I want you guys to participate. It's going to be less about me lecturing and more about getting this conversation going. And I'm going to bring in my Word document in a second, but I want you guys to consider that now. So in terms of your gym, whatever, wherever you go, you think about it, and what's the first observation, the first generality that comes to your mind when I ask you, you know, when you think about your gym's boot camp classes, exercise classes, whatever you want to call them, what's the first general observation that you think of that pops into your head? And I just wait to see if anybody will comment on that. So you know, feel free, just comment it out there. And then I'm going to bring in my Word document in a second. So no answers yet. So wait for some people to think about that and give me an answer. And then I'm going to tell you what I'm thinking about and why it's important in terms of metabolism in relation to biochemical and hormonal reality and balance. Dave says, people going with weight loss in mind. Yeah, okay, that's a good one. I was thinking even more general than that, And Linda saying, too hard for me. I guess you're thinking the classes are too hard for you. And that's another relevant thing we could get into as well, Linda. Good point. And I've talked about that before, but I'd like to get into that too. People being pushed to move without being educated. Andy, the physiques never change. These are really good comments. Adrian, random exercises to sweat. Wow, that's a really good one. But I'm thinking in even more general terms. If you had to look at it from above and you've never been in a gym before and you've looked into, you just peeked into the room for an exercise class or a boot camp class, what would be the first thing you would notice? And these are all excellent comments, by the way. Just we got some pretty smart people that tune into this show, and I'm so happy about that. But I'm going to bring in my Word document in a second. But you're all, everything everyone said is exactly right. But I want to think in even more general terms. So, and then we'll get to the ins and outs of why this matters in terms of biochemical and hormonal reality. So those are all, you know, really, really good responses. So Janine says fear. Okay, I don't know if that's, I don't know. Okay, maybe. I mean, this is an education for me then, if it's a fear and intimidation and things like that. I never looked at it that way. So I'm going to bring in my Word document now, and we're going to discuss this in real terms, in terms of exercise physiology, hormonal balance. Lydia, excellent comment. Not customized, regardless if it's your first time or your 50th time, not to mention body size, body weight, age differential, all these things that determine based upon someone's current conditioning level, work capacity, goal orientation, things like that. Excellent comments. So here's what I want to get to, folks, and I'm just going to bring mine into the screen there, and then I'll shrink my big fat head, and then I'm going to bring this up, and I will blow up my own comments here. So the first question is, and I'm going to blow these up so you can see them. Why is it that if you look into these classes, 90% of more of the people doing these exercise classes are women? I've been to gyms all over the world, and every time I peek into a gym's exercise class, it's always 90% or more women doing them. Why do you think that is? Why is that? So I want to get, that's what I want to explore. And if you think about it, I know you're going to make the same, draw the same conclusion. I see very few men jumping around and bopping around, in a boot camp class, you know, kicking their heels to their butts and, you know, yelling out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, you know, I want to get into why that may be the case. So that's the first thing. Okay. So that's a very, very important element to consider. So, good. Okay. Dave was going to say that very thing. All right. Excellent. So for me, even with among my own clients, here's the exercise blind spot that I was referring to earlier. So many ladies, even the ones who claim to know better, completely overemphasize their desire to burn calories. I'll have a lady who's maybe on a client of mine who's maybe on one of my MET programs, my metabolic enhancement training programs, and I'll move them to a hypertrophy program. And right away, their response will be, well, this feels easier. The last program was harder. I don't know if I can, you know, what happens on this program? What if I get, you know, gain fat and things like that? So this is one of those dilemmas that even people that should know better don't know better. And they lock into, all right, it's a constant thing about burning calories, all right? So I think that's one of the answers why so many ladies opt for the boot camp classes, because they think about burning calories. Now, Lydia is also making a very good point that many women are intimidated by the weight room. So boot camp with a bunch of other women is a comfort zone. That's fair enough. But again, if someone has a goal, why should that factor into a goal to improve yourself, because it's not going to. So that's an important factor as well. So the biochemical and hormonal reality here is not nearly so one-sided as looking at workouts in terms of calorie burning. So very, very important. And some people are just agreeing with you, Lydia. So that's a very important comment as well. But being a joiner, if your goal is to lose weight and lean out and sculpt your physique, being a joiner has nothing to do with that. So, you know, that's the first one. First thing that you've got to get through and understand. So biochemical hormonal reality is not nearly so one-sided as just thinking about calorie burning workouts. All right. So that's one important blind spot right there. Very, very important. And it's a true bias on the side of women. And that's very, very important. So one of the things, now the analogy that I'm going to get into and show you some proof of, the biochemical and hormonal reality of metabolism is a lot like your bank account. So I want you to ride this metaphor with me for a while, ride this analogy with me for a while, and think about that. And I'm just going to post that there, the bank account analogy, to understand, help you understand biochemical hormonal reality. So very, very important. So a lot of women are indeed under some misguided notion that if they, you know, lift weights, then they're going to develop bulky muscles. So that's another one of the biases there. So let's take this bank account. Now, this is in terms of understanding how your metabolism, biochemical, hormonal balance works. So it's a lot like understanding how your bank account works. So I want to just get into that. So if all you do in your bank account is spend, 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 the equivalent of burning calories, then soon you run out of money. And it's the same analogy here. If all you think about in terms of exercise is burn calories, burn calories, burn calories, then you're not thinking about other elements that go into biochemical and hormonal balance, biochemical and hormonal wellness. So think about that. Think about your biochemical hormonal balance as a bank account of sorts. So, and now I'm just going to expand the metaphor so you can follow me through on it. Hopefully people are seeing this just fine. So bank accounts and financial fitness, financial health, financial well-being, okay, are about striking a financial balance between your spending, your earning, and your saving. And you can look at your hormonal and biochemical health and wellness in exactly the same way. Okay, so that becomes something really, really important to consider. Now, I'm still getting comments coming in about, you know, the exercise classes, like Janine saying, to be honest, I don't really like working out and sharing machines with men. And that's, I guess, for you, that can be a completely legitimate comment, Janine, but where does that leave you in relation to accomplishing whatever goal you have for yourself cosmetically? So that would be what I would challenge that with you. Very, very important. So let's just continue with the bank account analogy. And by all means, if this resonates with you, then you know, hit your emoticons. I can finally see them. So I don't want to make sure that I'm saying stuff that you understand. So it's very important. And I'm going to get to some conclusions as well. So very important that you hang around until then. So consider the element, this with our bank account analogy. All right. Consider the element of proper investment, if you will. Your diet and training strategies need to reflect a long-term investment. All right. One that accumulates interest and eventually pays dividends. Now, how many of you are even thinking in those terms? No, because particularly the ladies have this blind spot of burn calories, burn calories, burn calories. This exercise makes me jump up and down and do burpees and be out of breath and all red-faced, and that's all I'm thinking about. So think about it in terms of biochemical and hormonal balance, things that can't be measured. All right. No, there's no accounting for that like you can for magic calorie consumption. But long-term investment, one that accumulates interest, one that pays dividends. If you only are focusing on calorie spending, then you get none of this. For instance, let's shift over to diet for a minute. Ketosis. I've talked about this a million times. Ketosis is an emergency metabolic state that reflects depletion, not investment. All right. So you can make the scale move that way for a little while. But what about the long-term health of that metabolic bank account in doing so? Because ketosis represents a depletion of glycogen. And I've talked in previous episodes that a depletion of glycogen sends a trigger to metabolic slowdown, metabolic shutdown, and all those other kinds of ramifications to that. So that's a really, really important element to consider. Now, to optimize metabolism here, all right, so let me just blow up point by point. You guys are following me along. To optimize metabolism, hormonal or biochemical fitness, you can't just focus on calories you spend. There must also be a focus on what you earn biochemically and hormonally. All right, healthy whole foods, the right kind of workouts, the right kind of workouts. See, now we start narrowing it down. What does the right kind of workout have to do with I'm more comfortable bouncing around with a bunch of other women. I'm not comfortable sharing equipment with men. That has nothing to do with the right kind of workouts for biochemical and hormonal bank account investment that will pay dividends. A focus on what you save in biochemical hormonal disposition and a focus on what you invest. Long-term training and nutritional benefits and their cumulative effects on metabolism and internal biochemical hormonal balance and sustainable weight control. Think about that in terms of the overall bank account of your metabolic profile, your overall metabolic fitness, wellness, balance, a lot like a bank account. So what this means is you can't just go out and demonize hormones like insulin and cortisol. I've talked about that in previous webinars as well. So that makes no sense, even though it's big in the fitness industry. And I have also, don't forget, I've also completely debunked the carbohydrate theory of carbohydrate and insulin. I debunked that several times ago. So yeah, very, very important. Is this resonating with you guys? By all means, hit your emoticons if it is, because I'm trying to impart some wisdom here that has it's going to help you people with your blind spots. So really, really important stuff. So you can't just focus on how sweaty your boot camp class or group workout makes you. You can't focus all year long on cardio as another example, because it's always meant as a short-term investment, cardio is, that stops paying off fairly quickly. So, I just had someone join with me last week. And the question is, do you handle my macros and do you handle this? And what about my training and my cardio? Well, if you're doing cardio all year long, then you've got no room to maneuver. There's no investment value there. There's no paying of dividends there. The only time cardio pays dividends is if you don't do it for a long period of time and then do it for a short period of time. And then it has some dividend value. It pays some accumulated interest. But it's the law of diminishing returns, as I've said many, many times. But in terms of someone who's just focused on burning calories, well, they've done their weights, now they need to jump on the treadmill or the elliptical so they can count how many calories they're burning. That's a blind spot in terms of how biochemical hormonal balance actually works. So now the same thing goes with metabolic training, okay? MyMet training, CrossFit, things like that. You can't just focus on metabolic training without balancing that with sound hypertrophy training, because training for lean mass, what does that do? Stimulates metabolism long term, stimulates hormonal investment in anabolic activity. When you're only thinking about calorie burning, you're only thinking about breaking down body tissues, and you're only thinking about catabolic activity. So you can't just focus on those things. Regardless of type of training, short term and long term recovery has to be considered as bank account earnings and potential earnings. So how many of you are thinking that way when you think about a given workout? So a lot of the times I'll assign a lot of hybrid training. And one of those days will be just to work on the strength lifts. And I'm just picking this randomly, but it'll be like one separate day is just the squat, the bench, the deadlift, and the overhead press. And then ladies in particular will balk at that because it's not quote unquote hard enough because it's low reps, higher load, because they're not thinking outside of any box other than burning calories. Oh, I have to rest too long between sets. It's not pushing me like the last program did. That kind of element is shows a blind spot in terms of thinking that, I'm not burning any calories. So Andy's just commenting, oh, he hasn't done any cardio at the gym in 11 years. I'm going to get to Andy in a minute. So very, very important that you guys understand this. So hopefully it's making sense to you. It's shaping up that metabolism, understanding biochemical hormonal balance as a bank account in terms of investment, savings, paying dividends, that kind of thing. So, and yet, here's the thing about the blind spot. It's an imprint. And that's the problem for people like me to try to educate and get people past. That imprint is really, really strong, especially in the ladies. And what I mean is, having even explained all of this, most of you are going to go right back to thinking and overthinking about how many calories you're burning in a workout, because you equate calorie burning with fat burning. And what's the number one thing, Abel diet principle, that I've been saying for years and years? Metabolism must be fed, not starved. If you're constantly thinking of starving off body fat, you're not feeding metabolism. Therefore, you're not considering accruing interest in your bank account, in your metabolic bank account. So it's very, very important. But there's a reason these are imprinted in your head. Like I'm just going to say here, if you just watch any infomercial for workouts or fitness equipment, I believe one of you already mentioned it in the comment section, you see all of this calorie burning emphasis over and over again. Oh, our new tread climber, it burns three times the calories in the same amount of time. And, you know, all this other kind of stuff that keeps imprinting on you that what matters is the calorie consumption, the calorie burning element of your workout. And I'm trying to submit to you and get you to understand that that's a very kindergarten understanding of human physiology and biochemical reality. It's not what's going to get you to the physique that you envision. And success leaves clues. And I want to get to that shortly, because I'm almost done. So we're going to get to your comments shortly, but I will post Andy's right away. Andy's just saying, I don't know how that got confused, but there you go. Andy's just saying, you know, the last time he did cardio was 11 years ago. So, and you all know, as Andy being a cover model, fitness model with 24/7 ripped abs. So let me expand upon this bank account analogy. So again, we're talking about biochemical, hormonal balance and wellness reality. And we're using the analogy of a bank account to explain that to you. So really, really, really important to understand. So it's like focusing on a tax refund from a government tax cut. Okay, that's all in the news lately. So let's examine that as well. Without seeing the bigger picture down the road, if that refund, your tax refund, has the consequence of ballooning the debt, then you and your next generation are going to pay for that dearly. If a tax cut goes along with a list of entitlements being taken away from you that you used to count on, then you aren't benefiting, because now you're going to have to pay out of pocket for those things, and you may even be worse off. And this is exactly how metabolism works as well. It works exact same way. Follow me here. A diet by deprivation, okay, is a lot like a tax cut. That will lead to weight loss as an immediate return, which is a lot like your tax refund that you get so excited about. But you're going to pay dearly for that long term, okay, in terms of metabolic downregulation and rebound body weight. Okay, so that's those entitlements being taken away from you because you haven't trained for them and you haven't properly dieted for them. Now, this is not complicated stuff, except that people choose to live in denial with hope over experience. So you keep falling for the same promise and you keep getting the same results. So it's a lot like getting people excited about a tax refund without getting them to examine the overall context, if that is good or bad. When I was a lot poorer and in the household I grew up in, I was always taught to believe that getting a tax refund was a really good thing. And wow, what a, you know, I got this huge free money that I'm looking at. When in reality, the reality is that the more money I have to pay means the better off I'm doing and the better my well-being is. So you have to start looking at training, not just as workouts. That's why the boot camp classes and all that stuff so limited, but you have to also look at them from a programming standpoint beyond workouts. So hopefully that's making good sense to you as well. So I'm almost done here. So to focus only on calorie burning and workouts and not much else is myopic, and it fails to see the bigger picture of how your body functions and how overall wellness, biochemical hormonal balance really works. You can't constantly focus on depleting your wellness bank account and think that that makes good sense. Now, the other thing is how incredibly unobservant people are. And I'm going to copy that and post it on the screen, because I'm going to use an example here. Now, one of the things being a sociologist taught me early in my education was to be constantly observant, to the point where now it's just an automatic for me. So I want to explain something to you. The time of the day that I go to a gym in the mornings, I get to observe a bunch of different things. One is the timing works out that when I arrive at the gym, there's a boot camp fitness class that's just about to end. And then about 10 minutes after that, there's usually one that's just about to start. So I observe most of the ladies going in and out of there. I've only seen one man that's actually participating. So it's 99.9% female. I've yet to, and they're all regular. So I've seen them now for 2 years. I've never seen any of them change. I see them come out of there red-faced, purple-faced, sweating. I've seen some of them exhausted. I've seen some of them injured. But I've never seen any of them change. Now, at the same time, so that's two classes that I've been observing for about 2 years, and people of different ages, different body shapes, different ranges of fitness that they're in or not in, different levels of body fat, which also, you know, bears the question, why are they all doing the same thing? But okay, but they're all jumping around, bouncing around, and you can see the looks on some of their faces are that they're doing something that the people on the gym floor aren't doing. Like they're accomplishing something that we're not, because we're not heavy breathing and we're not laying on the floor and we're not all clapping together at the end of the class and we're not all bouncing in unison and synchronicity to some fitness leader screaming 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 at the top of her lungs. And that's another story. But here's the thing. What I observed, I haven't seen any of those ladies change. Now, at the same time of day that I train, okay, I can think of four different examples, three of them ladies, okay? For one, there is Krista that you guys have seen in all my videos and star of my Great Glutes at Home program and soon to be Busy Woman at Home training product. So here's Krista. No one's ever seen jumping around in a fitness class. No one's ever seen her doing a minute of cardio, and she has an enviable female form, which nobody can deny. I mean, she just does. Now, that's a lady in her 20s. Now, there's another lady in our gym, Andy can testify to, who I usually wouldn't point out, but I point out because she could step on a figure competitor, bikini competitor stage anytime. Like, I mean, Monday to Sunday, 7 days a week, 52 weeks a year, she looks that fantastic. Not 5 months of starvation dieting. She's just a genetic elite specimen, a lot like a female version of Andy, if you will. Now, she's in her 30s, and I've talked to her. She has a full-time 40-hour-a-week job. She has three kids at home. All right. And she has a physique that would make everybody turn their heads, a little smaller than Krista. But like I said, she could compete. And I've watched her for 2 years to know that it wasn't just someone who dieted down to compete for and was in shape for 2 weeks. This is a lady that's been in incredible shape for 2 years, kind of like a female Andy, always ripped, always. All right. So, and then there's another lady that's just leaving when I get there. And I've talked with her, and I don't have their permission to use their name, so I'm not going to. But she's in her 50s. She's just a slightly younger than me because I'm really old. But and she looks great, too. Abs year round, you know, kind of body uplifted, glutes and stuff, you know, looks her age. So what I'm getting at here is now there's three ladies out on the gym floor. One's in their 20s. One's in their 30s, one's in their 50s, and they all look better than anyone jumping around, bouncing around in these group fitness classes. And yet no one within the fitness classes seems to make the connection and go, well, how come they're not in here and they're out there and they look like that and I look like this? Success leaves clues, folks, but why are people so unobservant of that? And that boggles my mind. Actually, here's an inside story. One of the Fitness Bunny group fitness class leaders actually walked up to Krista one day and said, you know, you come here every morning at the same time of day my class starts and you got no excuse. I want to see you in my class, as if Krista was missing something by doing her own workouts on the gym floor. It's like, huh? And it would be different if this lady actually compared to how Krista looks. And if you're going there to have a cosmetic advantage, then she shouldn't have even opened her mouth because it should have been Krista giving her advice. But this is the kind of blind spot that they have, that somehow these classes are a step above, or the, you know, they're even harder. It's not about how hard it is and how many calories you're burning. So once again, you need to be observant. The other thing there, the reason I have AS here, because that means Andy Sinclair. If people come now, here's Andy in the prime of his life, and you know him. You know, there's only one Andy, right? He's the top one percenter. But people come in and they see Andy and I both doing the same GPP, and no one's ever asked either one of us about it. No one's ever said, now that's fine in terms of not asking me. I'm just a nice old man in the gym. But when you see both Andy and me doing something no one else is doing, and I will say, I guess for my age, going on 57, that, you know, I would think I'm top notch, but Andy is definitely a whole other level. And not a single person has ever said, why are they doing that? No one's ever come up and said, why are you doing these like arm swings and leg swings and reach lunges? And they wouldn't even know it by name, but don't know. They just go over and they get on their cardio, they sit on their bike, they walk on their treadmill, and then they start working out. They're so unobservant as to what works and what doesn't work. And that is completely mind-boggling to me when success leaves clues and success is right there in front of you. So thinking of metabolism and the realities of the bank account analogy to understand biochemical and hormonal reality, someone signed in here under my name. I don't know how that's possible, but someone's commenting under my name. That's just really weird. I don't know who that is, but I don't know who has access to my name, but that's strange. I think if you guys see that or not. But so it's a very, very strange thing that people have all, they can witness all this success and understand that success leaves clues, but they don't observe it. They go blinders on into the exercise class. Like I said, at my own gym, there's female examples from each generation right there for them to look at, and they don't see it. And that blows my mind. So I'm going to end on that with another Abel success story. Look at this. This is my client, Ollie. Now, I don't have before pictures of Ollie because the reason he hired me when he was so big, he wouldn't let anyone take a picture of him without a shirt or anything like that. So on the left, you see Ollie before, and now you see him after, and he's holding out the sweatpants that he actually wore. So there you go. So he's holding out sweatpants that he used to wear, you know, a long time ago. And then now he's with me. He's got abs. He's being a little bit of a clown in these pictures because that's his nature. But look at the difference in the sweatpants and stuff. And I've never had Ollie bounce around in a class. We don't starve him. We have trained his metabolism. And now guess what? He is on the cycle. He's eating refeed meals. I would have liked to have posted a picture of his recent refeed he sent me, but I don't know how to do that, so I didn't get it involved. So, but check that out. So here's someone, and I train this client, of course, with the bank account analogy. He's not out there jumping around and you know, leaving it all on the floor. We're not worrying about calorie consumption. We don't count how many calories he takes in, and we certainly don't count how many calories he burns, and we don't measure macros, and we don't do any of this other stuff. I stick to the bank account analogy. Same thing we do with Andy. You know, same idea. So here's more real world success and how all that works. So I thought I would put that up there. Just a really, really nice guy. Happy to see him have the success that he has had. So very, very important. Look at that. Look at him holding out those sweatpants that used to fit him. I mean, that's just amazing. And how did he do that? He did it the Abel way: innervation training, sound diet strategy, using and employing the metabolic realities of the bank account, hormonal and biochemical balance. And it's just too bad that so many ladies, like I started with, so many ladies, even the ones that claim to know better, all right, completely overemphasize their desire to burn calories. So it's very, very, very important. So I just wanted to get that across, make sure that you understand that. I'm going to bury this now so I can get to your comments. And I'll just start where I was down before. So, I keep Janine just saying 4 years of Les Mills classes. That name keeps popping up. I don't know what that is or who that is, if it's even a male or a female. So, very, 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 you know, I've heard it, and I don't have the interest in researching it. So, who is this person that is signed in under my name? So that's just very, very weird. So, Janine's just saying, you know, changing the mindset is so powerful, it can be sustained long term, and choose to not follow the herd. I don't know. I mean, it boggles my mind. I'm sitting there in the gym, and I know that, you know, people can be as observant as I am, and I watch just as many people who aren't getting results, and I think, why aren't they scratching their heads? Why aren't they connecting with the people in the gym who are, and the people who look like $1 million, and querying them on it? It makes no sense to me when it's right there in their face. And like I said, they're all jumping around in the class, and you know, they're doing something. More power to them for exercising, but don't people want results from their exercise efforts? And ladies are particularly susceptible to this blind spot of, I got to breathe heavy, heavy, heavy. I got to be out of breath. I got to burn calories, you know, and all the rest of it. So really, really important. So just a shout out to Krista there. And then Lydia's just saying, I guess it's time to hit the weight room with the boys. And it's not just that, though. It's having the right workout. It's having the right approach. Like I said, Andy and I, going through our GPP, we're the only two in the gym that do that. And no one's ever asked either one of us anything about it, which is kind of a head scratcher. If there was a guy that looked like Andy in my gym back when I was young and hungry, he would have had to shoo me away. I would have been asking so many questions. So it's just very, very strange. So. And then Janine was just being honest enough earlier to say I was describing her to a T. So, another reason, Sherry's saying, to banish all Fitbits. Sure. But it goes beyond that too. A lot of people need to stop looking at exercise programs as one being harder than another one or easier than another one, when the real word is they're different from each other. So I said a few weeks back that I've got situational hypermetabolism from actually cutting out a workout day. I went from a 6-day training program to a 5-day training program that increased my volume on those days. And for the first 4 to 6 weeks, I was in hypermetabolic scenario by training less. And that's because I could make those observations because I didn't have that blind spot about, oh no, this is a whole other day of the week that I'm not working out now. So that kind of thing too. So very, very important. So, and Janine's just saying it's the opposite of what I thought for decades. Gym's imprint, all of that stuff. Let's jump around in a class and let's sweat. And we're doing more than that person out there in the weight room who's resting for 2 or 3 minutes between sets. Not necessarily. You're doing something different. You're not necessarily doing something better and you're not doing something more. And it should show results. So here's the thing. Most ladies are getting into this now and they're thinking calorie burning, calorie burning, calorie burning, because that equates to fat burning, fat burning, fat burning. And yet all these people I pointed out in the gym, Andy, Krista, the lady that's in her 30s and the other one over 50s, they're not jumping around in classes and they're not doing any of that. But you can bet they're probably eating well. And they're very, you know, it's very, very important in those terms. So really, really good stuff. So hopefully that resonates with all you guys. And then hopefully you did take the time and noticed my client Ollie there. So good. Good. Good comments. Any questions or comments? Now, I am going to do, Lydia's just saying she started doing GPP after my recommendations, investing in my Heart Gainers program. She always used to warm up on cardio. Which is just a waste of time. Unless your workout is cardio, then doing cardio doesn't warm you up for anything. So Janine's just saying, where to next? Well, that's up to you guys. I just wanted to get this out there because it just, it's so mind-boggling to me, because one of the reasons I was able to, no pun intended, but become an expert is because even before I had a grasp of the research, I was intently observing everything around me when I went to the gym because I was so hungry to learn, not just what was working, but what wasn't working. And it's amazing to me that how many people are just blind, like they just pay no mind to it. So, which is fine if you're just a person who wants to go to the gym, do your thing and leave. But if you say you have goals, then that's a really, really important thing. And you've got to be, like Dave said, it's a lot of it can boil down to one word. They're just indifferent. Now I'm assuming that people that tune into my type of show aren't indifferent. I assume that they have a love or a passion or an interest in actually getting something out of their training. My time is so valuable to me that I can't ever imagine thinking that I've wasted any of it on anything. So even when I'm just lounging, I'm lounging with a purpose, and that purpose is to lounge. So I can't imagine just being indifferent about maybe a diet meal I'm having, or a refeed day that I'm having, or a workout that I'm having. I'm not indifferent about anything about my life, but that's a great word to use, Dave. I appreciate you throwing it out there, because that seems to be what I think, or what I see. And as Janine said earlier on, sometimes people just go along to get along. And, you know, I don't like using the equipment with the men, or I don't like working with the weights, or I don't like, well, what's that got to do with what it takes to reach your goals? These are non sequiturs. It's just like the infomercials for the cardio equipment that folds under your bed. What's that got to do with what it takes to accomplish your goals? So this is the kind of blindness that I'm talking about, which is really, really important stuff to understand. So, and Rob's just saying, as you know, it's been happening for decades, started with Richard Simmons and then Tybo. And yeah, I mean, we see that all the time, right? Beachbody and all the rest of it. And, you know, it's all about making you fit the program. But now it's all about, you know, especially for ladies, calorie burning, calorie burning, calorie burning. So, and that's just not the bank account reality of human metabolism and biochemical hormonal balance. You have to straighten those things out, and you can't do that if all you think about is how many calories you're burning rather than the system that you're building. And that's the real, real important thing. So final note, next week, what I'm going to be doing, Pam's just saying, seeing changes with the Heart Gainer, the cycle diet, but oh so slow. Yes, but slow and steady. You know, there's a reason the hare and the tortoise is such an old one. So very, very important. So Nadim is just saying, Janine, you could check out Scott's videos on YouTube. That makes sense as well. So who is this person posting under my name? When did a calorie become a thing that must be destroyed? I want to know who's posting under my name there. So Janine's just saying, all week I've been thinking about changing my gym workouts, and now here you're confirming what I couldn't put into words. So good. I mean, you know, it's all about challenging your reference points if your reference points aren't working. Now, the problem there is people will opt for short-term solutions that have long-term consequences. So they'll take something that seems like it's working now for something that'll have long-term consequences down the road, you know, e.g., I can fix your metabolism. And how they do that is they put you right back on a type of diet that damaged it to begin with. So just because someone puts you on a different form of the same thing, it's still the definition of insanity to do the same thing and expect a different result. So, you know, I get all these former competitors with metabolic issues. They've gained 40 pounds and then they want me to be able to tell them I can fix them. And what they mean by that is, please help me lose weight. So they go to another guru who will sell them the promise and not the result, put them on something stupid like intermittent fasting or keto, and then they'll be all happy. Oh, it's working. It's great. I'm losing weight. There's nothing to do with fixing your metabolism or resetting it. It's actually the same thing that caused the problem to begin with. So that's the definition of insanity. You went back on a diet to lose weight, which is what caused your issues to begin with. That's what I'm talking about in term of bank accounts. So in terms of who's posting under my name, Pam saying, is your wife logged in under your account? I don't have a wife, Pam. I have an ex-wife. So I'm not married. So I don't know who that is logged in under my account, but it's very strange. So wouldn't maintenance or surplus calories be the only thing that would actually help with your metabolism? No, not necessarily, Lauren. My cycle diet operates under cycling relative deficits with well-timed overfeeding. So we go through a cycle of regularly planned underfeeding with whole healthy whole foods, and then we deliberately overeat to ramp up and create a hypermetabolic state to burn fat. And that also contributes to the overall bank account. That's all in my cycle diet as well. So really important stuff. Now, one thing I want to, it looks like the comments have stopped. So one of the things I want to comment on then, Lydia's just saying, I hope you weren't hacked. Have my tech guy look into it. Yeah, because I couldn't even access my Facebook page earlier. I didn't even know I was going to get this on. But whoever it is, at least they're commenting, in good stead, in good faith. It looks like they're contributing, but it's very strange. So that's not me making those comments, folks. I don't know who that is. But what I wanted to say is, now next week, I am going to be going live in the morning with all my workouts for the next week. But here's the thing. I want to be going live next week with my workouts, not to impress you with my physique. I'm going on 57 years old. Those days are long gone. But I'm going to be doing it to impress upon you, okay, what expertise is and what it can do. So all next week is going to be about training with limitations. I have very severe limitations, osteoarthritis in both shoulders, and limitations from previous double laminectomy in my back in the year 2000, things like that. But I'm able, with expertise, to train around it and train around it pretty well. So I'm going to be going live next week with all my workouts. And within the workouts, I'll be taking questions about training and about the training I'm doing. So Janine's just saying, that's just a heads up for everybody. Janine's just saying, guess I'm buying the cycle diet. There's also a cycle diet course, Janine. It's at thecycle.diet. That's just, you know, HTTP, thecycle.diet, and you can get either the book and or the course there. So Gerard's just saying, get a great coach too, like Scott. Appreciate that. Gerard was a former client of mine, so I guess that comes with, a good one. So let me just, one more time, I'll just reduce myself here. And then just wanted to, one more time, show you guys
what the bank account approach can accomplish. So that's my client, Ollie, again. And I'll just show you that. And then my client, Ollie, again, holding out those sweatpants that used to fit him so well. And now by doing it, he's not starving. He's not hitting a wall. None of those things. So really, really important. I think we should just probably end on that. So hopefully that inspires a few people. So yeah. So yeah, you can find all my books and my courses at my Scott Abel Fitness website. And numbers were low today, but probably the time of day and stuff, but with the time of year, I've got other obligations. So for the weekend. So hopefully you guys will hit share. Hopefully you guys, this resonated with you as well. So please hit your share button, get people involved. Let's get a conversation of intelligent approaches to all this stuff instead of the Tom, Dick and Harry foolery that passes for intelligence out there, which is completely mind-boggling to me, but also disappointing to me after four decades representing the industry as an expert to seeing what passes for expertise now is pretty disappointing stuff. So anyway, that's it for me, folks. So thanks for being out there. If you weren't out there, it wouldn't make a lot of sense for me to be in here. So I'll see you probably next time, but Monday for my workouts. So really, really important stuff. And I will see you all then. So cheers.